न प्रत्याहाति कीर्तितः
सुत उवाच
कृपया स्नेह वैक्लव्या सुतो विरामकर्षितः आत्मेश्वरम् अचक्षानो
न प्रत्याहाति पीडितः
Sutuvacha.
Sutta
Goswami said,
Kripaya,
out of full compassion,
Snehavaiklavyad,
mental derangement due to profound affection,
Sutta,
Sanjaya,
Viraha Karshitaha,
distressed by separation.
Atma Ishwaram,
his master,
Achakshanaha,
having not seen.
Na,
did not.
Pratyaha,
replied.
Atipiditaha,
being too aggrieved.
Translation.
Sutta Goswami said, because of compassion and mental agitation, Sanjaya, not having seen his master, Dhritarashtra, was aggrieved and could not properly reply to Maharaj Yudhishthira. Please repeat.
Sutta Goswami said,
because of compassion and mental agitation,
Sanjaya,
not having seen his own master,
Dhritarashtra
was aggrieved and could not properly reply to Maharaj Yudhishthira. Purport. Sanjaya was the personal assistant of Maharaj Dhritarashtra for a very long time, and thus he had the opportunity to study the life of Dhritarashtra. And when he saw at last that Dhritarashtra had left home without his knowledge, his sorrows had no bound. He was fully compassionate toward Dhritarashtra because in the game of the Battle of Kurukshetra, King Dhritarashtra had lost everything, men and money, and at last the king and the queen had to leave home in utter frustration. He studied the situation in his own way because he did not know that the inner vision of Dhritarashtra had been awakened by Vidura and that therefore he had left home in enthusiastic cheerfulness for a better life after departure from the dark well of home. Unless one is convinced of a better life after renunciation of the present life, one cannot stick to the renounced order of life simply by artificial dress or staying out of the home. Om Jnanati Mirandasya Jnananjana Shalakaya Chakshurun Militam Dena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha. Shri Chaitanya Manopishtam Stapitam Yena Bhutale Swayam Rupa Kadamayam Tatati Swapatantikam Adadhanashtradam Tanter Itam Yache Puna Puna Shiman Rupa Padam Bojao Rajoham Shambhave Bhave Vande ham Sri Guru Sri Yuta Padakamalam Sri Kurun Vaishnavamscha Sri Rupam Sagrajatam Sahagana Raghunatham Vitam Tam Sajivam Sadvaitam Sadvadhutam Parijana Sahitam Krishna Chaitanya Devam Sri Radha Krishna Padan Sahagana Lalita Sri Vishakam Vitamcha He Krishna Karuna Sindho Dinabando Jagatpate Gopesha Gopika Kanta Radha Kanta Namostute Tapta Kanchana Gaurangi Radhe Vrindavaneshwari Vrishabhanu Sute Devi Pranamami Hari Priye Namashreshtam manamapi shachiputra matra sarupam rupam tasya gajam aruparim maturim goshtavatim Radha kundam girivadamaho radhika maravasham Prapto yasya prititukripaya shri gurum tam natosmi Vanchakalpa turubhyascha kripa sindubhya evacha Patitanam bhavanebhyo vaishnavebhyo namo namaha Matsamo nasti papatma naparadi chakaschana parihare pilajame kimbruve purushottama yuvatinam yata yuni yunam chau yuvatau yata mano bhiramate tadvan mano me ramatam twayi bhumau skalita padanam bhumeva balambanam twayi jata paradanam Tameva sharanam prabho Da balabe radhe prate twamaham sada Twadiyam iti janatu Govindo mam twayasaha Radhe vrindavanadishe karunamrita vahani Kripaya nijapadabja dasyamayam atitam Tadvajastrinam padurenam abhikshnasa Dasam harikato gitam punati bhuvanashriham Hantaya madhura bala haridasavaryo yadrama krishna charanasparasha pramodaha Manam tanoti sahago ganayasta yo yat paniya suyavasa kannana kannamulai Jaya shri krishna chaitanya prabhu nityananda Sri Advaita Garadhara Srivasari Gaura Bhaktavinda Panchatattvatmakam Krishnam Bhaktarupa Sarupakam Bhaktavataram Bhaktakyam Namami Bhaktashaktikam Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama Rama Rama, Rama Hare Hare Gaur Premanande Haribo Sutuvacha kripaya sneha vaiklavyat sutoviraha karshitaha admeshwaram achakshano napratya hati piditaha. Sutta Goswami said, because of compassion and mental agitation, Sanjaya, not having seen his own master, Dhritarashtra, was aggrieved and could not properly reply to Maharaj Yudhishthira. Strong words in this purport. Sneha vaiklavyat, mental derangement due to profound affection. This was the relationship between the master and the servant. And after separation, there was mental derangement. And this is the extent to which a servitor becomes invested in the cause of his master, that after separation there's mental derangement, but it's due to affection being separated from that person. And this was the relationship between Sanjaya and Dhritarashtra. And also we have viraha karshita, distressed by separation. So he doesn't know at this point the cause for Dhritarashtra leaving. He doesn't know that he had been awakened by the words of Vidura. And in the purport, Prabhupada mentions this. He said he studied the situation in his own way because he did not know that the inner vision of Dhritarashtra has been awakened by Vidura, then, and that therefore he had left home in enthusiastic cheerfulness for a better life after departure from the dark well of home. So this purport and verse altogether invokes a very a pathetic scene. That is, in the sense of pathos, the emotion is coming out. In the household, we see that both Yudhishthira and now Sanjaya, who finds out that his master is gone, become overwhelmed with this lamentation that the king is gone. And on the other side, there's this cheerfulness of Dhritarashtra leaving behind the home. And this is the ongoing controversy in the material world. Practically speaking, there's a dichotomy here because we're a combination of matter and spirit, and there's always this kind of wrangling with the emotions that goes on here in as we're navigating our way through this lifetime. And on one side, I become easily attached to hearth and home or any kind of creature comfort I get used to in this world. Prabhupada once on a morning walk had stopped with a group of his leaders, many of them sannyasis, and he pointed with his cane to a pile of bird dung on the ground, and he said, "What does this mean?" And they were all thinking, "Well, it's bird dung, Prabhupada. What do you mean? What does it mean?" And somebody ventured that the obvious, which was, "Well, it's bird droppings." And Prabhupada said, "I know it's bird droppings. What does it mean?" And then no one came forth with an answer, so Prabhupada said, "It means that the bird's attached to that one branch because he lives up there." And he relieves himself right underneath the tree. That's why there's a pile. And so every living entity in this material world becomes attached to a certain circumstance and think this is it. And Prabhupada noted once when he saw in Howrah Station a homeless man, and he had a collection of half-burned firewood, and he dragged it with him wherever he went, thinking that he had some great fortune, and he was attached to it. Practically speaking, from top to bottom, Abrahma Bhuvana Loka Punar Avartino Arjuna, everything's burned firewood in this material world, half-burned, and I think that it has some relevance, and I become attached to it. And the emotions that are tied up in my relationships in this material world are intense, because as a prani, a living entity with consciousness and sentience, I have emotion and I become attached. And this emotion becomes tied up in my relationships with the people I love, my wife, my children, my family, and so on. And we see that Dhritarashtra had become fully entangled in his situation in the palace, even though it was an embarrassment because of the intrigues he had propagated against his other relatives, and now he was being maintained by them. But still, he didn't want to leave it until he got outside help from Vidura, who came and told him that you're embarrassing yourself and you're also missing the opportunity to utilize your human life to slip out of this material engagement and come to the highest spiritual perfection. And particularly profound is this statement that Dhritarashtra had been awakened by Vidura and that therefore he had left home in enthusiastic cheerfulness for a better life after departure from the dark well of the home. This analogy of dark well is profound if you think about it. Wells are dark and they're dangerous if you fall into them. So sometimes this allurement of material comfort, especially in the form for a man it's a woman, for a woman it's a man, and the promise that goes with that, which is described Pumsa Striya Mantini Bhava Mitam Toyomito Hridaya Grantamahu Atogriya Kshetra Sutapta Vitar Janasya Moho Yamahammamiti. Not necessarily a promise, but there's a promise that if you combine the two, you're going to be obligated to certain kinds of things. You have to get a house, you have to get a job, you have to work hard to maintain, and you'll also develop a hard knot within the heart that's very difficult to overcome. And the well, wells, sometimes people dig wells and then the house is abandoned, the house decays, deteriorates, it goes away, but the well stays there, and there can be a very deep well, and then it gets covered over by grass, and somebody walking in that field may not see it and fall in, and then they're stuck. And all you can do when you're at the bottom of the well and you can't get out is cry out for help. And if somebody comes and lowers a rope down they're the greatest savior, then they can pull you out. So in this situation, Dhritarashtra was like this. He was stuck at the bottom of a dark well. And Vidura came and he lowered this rope of mercy down for Dhritarashtra and by giving his strong words. And this is what a sadhu does. A sadhu cuts. He cuts the material attachment, the rope within the heart, by speaking strong words and giving sometimes shocking advice that you're attached, you should get out, so that the person can actually take advantage of the short amount of time that we have in the human form of life to come out of the situation. And this is a joyful awakening for someone who realizes suddenly, by the mercy of a sadhu, that there's a higher prospect in life. And in the next sentence, Srila Prabhupada mentions that this is absolutely necessary for renunciation. Vishaya vinivartante niraharasadehina rasavarjam rasopyasya param jishva nivartate. We, although renouncing in this world, may remain attached to the objects that we're renouncing. However, when we experience a higher taste, we abandon them and move on to the better thing. That's the nature of the soul, the prani. He wants the better thing. And therefore, it's incumbent upon us to develop that taste. We have to see it for ourselves. Otherwise, we will fall away. Maya is a reflection, but it looks just like the real thing. And it's easy as a living entity to get faked out by that reflection and think it's the real thing. Everyone's faked out by it. From Tattabana, Tejo Mridam, Tejovari Mridam Vinimayo Yatra Trishargo Mrisha. That this, all even the demigods and everyone think it's real, but actually it's a play of the three modes of material nature. Everyone becomes entranced by it. So it's really important to take hold of the rope that's being given to us and take full advantage of that. And we have to get a direct experience for ourselves. We actually have to see the higher pleasure that's available. Let me read the sentence. Unless one is convinced of a better life and renunciation, after renunciation of the present life, one cannot stick to the renounced order of life simply by artificial dress or staying out of the home. That applies to any kind of vow that we take, chanting the holy names, following the four regulative principles, reading a certain amount every day. There's great kings and wise people, even in the Bhagavad Gita, Krishna says in at least a couple of places that even a person who's intelligent, he's a kafi, he's learned, can be swept away by the senses. And therefore, it's necessary to get a higher taste in order to give up the lower taste. So that's our job every day. Your job is to get that higher taste. So if anybody asks you what your job is to... And if you have to write it on a disembarkation form when you're landing in a country, occupation is... Getting a higher taste. That's our occupation. You should try for that and that alone to get a higher taste. And that's available. It's actually available because through the vibration of the Srimad Bhagavatam and the holy names and the worship of the deity, association with devotees, living in the holy dham, many different processes of devotional service, we can get a higher taste. And that's the only hope that we have for remaining disentangled from the material world. I'm going to stop short there and take reflections and questions. Sri Govinda Datto Prabhu.
Very nice comments on the Prabhupada. I was just asking about the... Unless one is convinced about a better life after renunciation... That is like synonymous to faith, like one has a faith on the higher life after renunciation. So how to develop that faith? Many times we hear like there are desire fulfilling tree in the Goloka and Kamdhenu cows, and still we to give up things is very difficult unless we have the faith. And yeah, we may not reach perfection in one lifetime, but Krishna promises also, Konte Pratijanati Name Bhakti Pranishadi. He'll be given next chance in next life to start from in the family of devotees. So how do we have faith to give up the lower things? Although we theoretically knows this, but still there is some attachment.
Japa. Really good japa. If you concentrate on really good japa, you'll get a taste. And there's a whole science to that, what it means to chant japa. You can study it up and down. And the best thing is to dedicate yourself to that. And when I say dedicate, I could say that give your full attention to it every day. Plan for it and give your full attention, because that's what we have. We have our attention. We have an attention span. And you can increase that attention span by practice. Pramanais tat saracharais tarabhyasar nirantaram. This, when we were reading the Brahma Samhita this morning, this really stuck out, stuck in my mind. Tarabhyasar nirantaram means constantly practice. And with madanga, you have to sit down and practice it, right? Otherwise, you won't get better. You won't get stronger. Abhyas, it means you have to do it over and over again. And in the process of chanting the holy name, we need to practice. So as we practice and give our attention to the holy name, and naturally we'll develop spiritual qualities. We'll feel detachment. We'll get knowledge. And in that experience, we'll become encouraged. We'll feel joyful from the experience. And even if it's a little bit, we have to get it every day. I contend that you should not go away empty-handed. This helps you to pay attention. If you have this vow that I will not go away empty-handed from my japa this morning, you should think like that, that I'm not leaving without something here. And so you should think like that when you start, that I have to get something. I have to feel some kind of connection with Krishna. I have to hear the holy name, even if it's one time. Even one syllable I have to hear, but I got to get something. And in that, you should try and put your full attention and bring it back to the holy name. This is practicing. Tarabhyasya nirantaram. And you have to practice constantly. And if you do that, in one moment in the day, you'll experience something. I had this experience. I was chanting my japa. I had to use the restroom. So I walked there. I put my bead bag down. Then I thought, when I closed the door, I said, keep chanting. Lord Chaitanya actually anointed one of the devotees as as an acharya, because he said, you know, even when you go to pass, you should keep chanting. And he said, your name is Gopal Guru. His name was Gopal. He was just a kid, but then he was called Gopal Guru, and he became a great acharya. He said, chant even when you go to relieve yourself. So when the call of nature is there, keep chanting. So I remembered that, and I was chanting japa, and then I said, okay, keep chanting. And I know this is a funny example, but just in that moment when I had that impetus, continue chanting, and I did, I felt some ecstasy that the holy name is always there, no matter where you go. And in every situation, you can take shelter and continue. And I think just in the fact that I said, continue, don't stop. Take this advice. Prabhupada says in the Bhagavad Gita, you must chant Hare Krishna without stoppage. Meditate on what that means. Someone might say, I can't do that. Well, figure it out. You know, that's the answer to your problem. It's like one devotee was telling me when he was distributing books that you know, he was explaining the Bhagavatam and, you know, religion stuff. He said, so what are you trying to tell me? I should, like, study all these things and try to, you know, figure out what's the best? And he goes, yeah, you know, that's what a human form that is what I'm saying, you know. But in material life, we think, I'm so preoccupied, I can't chant, I can't read, I have so many other duties to do. That's the problem. I'm distracted by everything else. But if you make this the science of your life, how to chant without stoppage, what does that mean? And I mean, that's a big topic. Why are you doing this without stoppage? Your mind will ask you that. Don't you have better things to do? Don't you have more important things to do than chant Hare Krishna without stoppage? Haridas Thakur didn't have anything better to do. He chanted without stoppage. He was the Namacharya. Someone say, can't you do something else? And he's like, there's a lot of other things to do, but I like this the best. And the Shastra says, yes, this is the best thing. There is no other thing. So we should fortify ourselves with this understanding that the holy name is everything. And by doing it without stoppage, or at least doing it in a very regulated way, that we're giving full attention when we have the opportunity every day, our full effort. In any practice, Madhunga teacher was telling me that you can practice Tariqeta, which is a hand practice, and you can sit there and watch television at the same time. And he said, you won't get the same result as if you actually sit there and listen to how your hand is hitting the Madhunga and such. So this abhyas, this practice, is very important. There are rewards to that. Sometimes we'll chant japa, you won't feel anything profound, but the second after you finish, you put your bead bag down, walk out your door and look out, and the world looks completely different to you. You'll feel some ecstasy vibrating in the environment. You'll look at trees and water and the sky, and you'll think, oh, I'm in a universe. It's coming from Krishna. The knowledge and detachment come in a causeless way. Haitukiya pratyata. It just comes out from this process of associating with Krishna. So try to get something, and try to be happy and blissful. It's your duty to be blissful. Radhana Swami once told me, he said, your only duty in life is to be blissful. Especially if you're a manager, you have to be blissful. So what do you have to do to be blissful? Because you can't manage unless you're blissful. Everyone starts getting on your nerves. Why are they bothering me? Not again, you know. And if you're not able to rise above it by being blissful. And there's only one way to be blissful, and that's to associate with Krishna. Through the Bhagavatam, through the holy names, you got to get it. Rakshit Jariwala Prabhu is on to some shlokas, I can tell.
Well, I had some reflections actually on that last statement in the purport, because it's very profound, where it is saying that unless one is convinced of a better life after renunciation of the present life, one cannot stick to the renounced order of life simply by artificial dress or staying out of the home. Such a person is a pretender, as the Bhagavad Gita says. And I was reminded of a cluster of verses in the third chapter of the Bhagavad Gita, Karma Yoga, where Sri Krishna addresses it. And it's in the Shloka book, starting with verse 3.4 on page 51, and actually goes all the way to verse 3.8 on page 52. And essentially, Sri Krishna starts by saying that not by merely abstaining from work can one achieve freedom from reaction, nor by renunciation alone one can attain perfection. And so he's pointing out that someone wants perfection and say, I would withhold all material activities in this world, or I will just go to the forest for renunciation without having attained purity, as it's discussed in the purport, he says one cannot attain perfection. Then he points out in 3.5 that everyone is forced to act helplessly according to the qualities that he or she has acquired from the modes of nature, that no one can refrain by doing something even for a moment. And then he comes to 3.6, which I think is the key verse here. This is the karma indriyani samyamya ya aste manasha smaran indriya arthan vimudatma mithya chara sa uchyate. One who restrains the senses of action, but whose mind dwells on sense objects, certainly deludes himself and is called a pretender. And in the purport, Srila Prabhupada points out that unless one has attained some purity, even taking on yogic meditation cannot have value. Some people make display of yogic meditation, or even in public sometimes bluff that they are into religious thing and this and that, but their minds are still dwelling on sense objects and they are still attached materially. So they are pretenders, and they may act to go to the forest or change dress, but yet they are impure. It is not going to lead to perfection. So in 3.7 then, Sri Krishna points out that on the other hand, if a sincere person tries to control the active senses by the mind and begins karma yoga, Krishna consciousness, without attachment, he is by far superior. So he's pointing out that merely controlling the mind but not positively engaged in Krishna consciousness, it is not going to sustain one's effort towards perfection. So this last sentence of the purport that is mentioned here, that one cannot stick to the renounced order of life simply by artificial dress or staying out of the home, is nicely supported by these verses from the Bhagavad Gita.
Thank you. Really nice series. And I'm glad you brought to light this word artificial. Artifice, any kind of artificial behavior, doesn't give the result one's looking for. And this is something that's related to sincerity, not trying to cover over what my faults are, which is the very root of the word sincerity. It means without covering up the faults. I do what I have to do in order to make advancement from the position I'm in now, begin by engage the active senses with what I'm qualified for. And from that situation, I will make advancement. So artificial dress, I shouldn't try to delude myself. I should take what I can, what is the service that's been given to me at this time, and perform that the best that I can. And from there, I'll make advancement, further advancement. Thank you very much. We're going to end class here. So we have Guru Puja, we have Prasadam. Some of us are going down to, what is it, Green Acres, Green Fields, Gold Mine. What is it called, Malini? Green something? Evergreen, which last time meant evergreen with cash. Because that's what it means, evergreen. So some devotees are going to Evergreen to sell sets of Chaitanya Charitamrita door to door. We're going to make it ever golden, evergreen to ever golden. And some devotees are going to Foster City. And where are other devotees going? Evergreen, Foster City, where else?
Indian store also, cash and carry.
Cash and carry, all these green cash, everything. Here's the microphone for you.
Prabhuji, also Bishwe Prabhu wants to go to Sanatan Dharma Kendra in Sunnyvale, but he's first going to try in Sunnyvale Temple because today they are celebrating Holi festival there.
Oh,
so
okay.
He's
Tell
going
him
to
wear
try
his old clothes.
Try and pair with Tirtha Prabhu, and then he will go there. If they allow, they will distribute. Otherwise, he will go to Sanatan Dharma.
They should make a special presentation that relates Chaitanya Charitamrita to Holi, to show them. You know, connect Holi to Chaitanya Charitamrita.
I told
and
him
say
also.
This is special for Holi, this whole set.
I will tell him.
Okay, so we have about 4 spots, and it's an unlimited city. It's wide open. Also, don't forget that these are just some spots you can use, but also use your innovation, your imagination. There may be people in Russia that need sets, or and anywhere on the internet, your friends on Facebook, wherever you go, but put out the word, because the third law of book distribution is?
The more you show, the more.
But that's the one we say at least twice, right?
The more you show, the more you sell.
That is, the more you show, the more you sell. If we have all these cases and we don't take them out today, how many will we sell? Maybe some, because people will walk in the temple, right? And they might see them here. But if we left them at Rakshit Jariwala's house, how many would we sell? Maybe something, because people come over to his house. But if we left it at the BBT warehouse, how many would we sell? Approximately. Approximately zero. Because you can't see them. But as soon as you bring them out, they've gone to Rakshit Jariwala's house, the chances of them being sold go up. And then when we bring them over here, the chances go up even more, right? Can we do a scientific analysis, some of the engineers here, about what is it called? Oh, the PhD and PhDs in here. They could do this as a PhD thesis preparation of how the principle, the more you show, the more you sell, works. I'd like to see that. Now, if we take them out and we actually show them to people door to door, store to store, at the holy festival, on the internet, just mention it, bring it up, how many do you think we sell? We have no idea, but it's a lot more than if they stay here, right? So point is, show these books, take them everywhere. All you have to, you don't have to be expert, you don't have to know how to do anything, just show them, like you used to do in grammar school. They have show and tell, and you can bring in your hamster and say, here, this is my hamster Pinky. Look at them. Just pull out the book and show people and say, this is a beautiful golden book that will change your life. And actually, I'm writing the history right now, some of the history of the first big books that were ever distributed. And one devotee named Thakur Haridas, he's a Canadian. He sold the first, well, it's disputed. There's some dispute about who actually sold the first book. Actually, Prabhupada did it at a Ratha Yatra festival, because they brought him the Krishna books and he sold them all to the audience without even keeping one for himself. And when the devotees took the books out door to door, Thakur Haridas, he sold one, the first book that Mahatma told me that he knows of, the first big book that was sold on the street, was sold to a drunk. And they went to Prabhupada had said, he told the devotees, anyone who travels and preaches and doesn't care for where they stay or what kind of facility they have, he said, I take the dust from their feet and I put it on my head. So Mahatma, that the devotees then went crazy. And he said, we were driving in the freezing cold winter and we didn't even know if we had a full tank of gas, but we didn't care. We just go to the next place. And he said, we went to one town and there was a blizzard going on, so we went out on the street and we started chanting, because Prabhupada said this thing. And there was nobody out except for the town drunk, because he didn't know any better. He was so drunk. So he walked down the street and Thakur Haridas approached him with a Krishna book. And Mahatma said, everyone in the party was thinking, you're crazy, he'll never take one. And then next thing you know, he gave $8 and he took the Krishna book. Haribol! And then Thakur Haridas, he started selling two or three big Krishna books a day. And before that, devotees had only sold maybe two or three a month. And so they asked Haridas, Thakur, what are you telling people to sell the book? And he said, I'm telling them I'm in ecstasy. I'm in ecstasy. And that's how he was selling the books. But the point was, they took the books out and they started showing them to people. And that's what started the revolution of books going out. So the second law of book distribution is? Get books. Because you can't sell books that you... Yeah, it's one of the laws of thermodynamics. You can look it up. And if you get the books and then you show the books, then your percentages, which will come out in a PhD thesis paper later, go precipitously upward in the process of book distribution. So today we're going to show, we're going to get books. All these books must go. All this whole stack here must be cleared out. Our policy is no book left behind. We got that from George Bush, George W. Bush. But we changed it from no child left behind. Ours is no book left behind. We thank you to George W. Thank you, W. He may be watching. I know he likes this kind of thing. All right. Srimad Bhagavatam ki. Srila Prabhupada ki. Chaitanya Charitamrita ki. Gaura Premanande.
Hare Krishna, Prabhu.
Oh, we have some gifts. Oh, do you have a list of who was on time? So the first 10 people who made it to the Harinam last night will receive a special gift this morning. Are you ready?
Yes.
First okay, name them off.
Our dear most, His Grace Ramananda Sakha Prabhu.
Ramananda Sakha! Haribo! Please come up and take your gift. This is out of deep appreciation. Hare Krishna. That's a picture of Prabhupada's lotus feet. Can you show it? Hare Krishna. Okay.
Trisha Prabhu.
Who?
Trisha Prabhu.
Trishab! Hare Krishna. Give him a big hand. Come on.
His Grace Shyam Chandra Prabhu.
Shyam Chandra! Haribo! Hare Krishna.
Venkatesh Prabhu.
Venkatesh! He's not here. Who will take it for him? Okay.
Actually, and Charan Dhari Prabhu. Chakra Dhari Prabhu.
Chakradhari.
Charan.
Oh, do you see him?
Padmanuga Mataji.
Okay, who could take for Chakradhari? Okay. Here's Chakradhari's.
Padmanuga Mataji. I think one more was. And Jagannath
who?
Prabhu. I don't know it's some devotees. Padmanabhan. Padmanuga Mataji.
Padmanabham. Who will give to Padmanabham? Padmanabham? You do? Okay, give him his gift.
Jagannath Prabhu.
Jagannath. For Jagannath?
Yeah, Jagannath Prabhu.
Where's Jagannath? You'll give to him? Okay. We're getting down to the wire here. There's only three or four more.
Padmanath Jagannath.
Padmanatha Jagannatham. Padmanabham. Oh, that Padmanabha Jagannath. Oh, okay. You can give to him. I'm sorry. Of course. You said Mataji. That's what threw me off. Because I didn't know about Padmanabha. I was a little off on that. Okay, who else? Three more.
Myself.
Yourself, Haribal. Two more.
I think this one, but last and not least, His Grace Vaisesika Prabhu.
No, there's two. There was 10 here, the first 10 people.
Yeah, actually, Kinjal Mataji and all three. Hiten Prabhu. Hiten. Oh, sorry, yeah, just actually. Hiten Prabhu, Kinjal Mataji, and Prabhuji.
That's all one person?
Yeah.
I hope so, because I only have two pictures. Haribo. Okay, and who else? One bonus, because I don't get one.
Actually, there were three, so any two.
Well, is it a family, or did they arrive together, or what?
Yeah.
Three of us, that is Hansapriya Mataji, Sonal, and I, followed at that
time. Okay, here you go. Rakshit Prabhu? No, for you, and you fight it out amongst yourselves. Haribo! Hare Krishna. Thanks for being there. It's a show of force when we come at 6:59 p.m. Now let's have Guru Puja. Hare Krishna. This morning we're leaving for book distribution at 11 o'clock. So we're going to have a short Guru Puja and then prasadam. Is that okay, Hansapriya? Are you ready back there? We're walking out the door at 11 o'clock this morning for the book distribution. Hare Krishna. Bando mui savadana mate. Bando mui savadana. Jahar prashade bhai bhavato priya ja. Krishna prapti hoy jaha. Krishna prapti hoy jaha. Padma Bhakya Chitete Koriya Aikya. Arna Kori Ho Mane Asha. Arna kori ho mani asha. Shri Guru Charani Rati Esheu Tamagati. Jai Prashade Pure Sarva Asha. Jai Prashade Pure Sarva Asha. Dandilo che janme janme prabhu she. Chakudandilo che janme janme prabhu she. Divya gyan hride prakashito. Divya Gyan Hride Prakashito. Prema Bhakti Jauhite Abhidya Vinasa Jate. Prema Bhakti Jauhite Abhidya Vinasa Jate. Vidhikai Jahara Charito. Vidhikai Jahara Charito. Shri Guru Karuna Sindhu Adama Janada Bandhu. Karu Nashindu Adama Janara Bandhu Lokana Lokeda Jivana Lokana Lokeda Jivana Prabhu kora doya deha more pada chaya Ha Prabhu kora doya deha more pada chaya Ebe jash kushik tribhuvana Bejash kushik tribhuvana Jaya Prabhupada 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 Jaya Prabhupada Jaya Prabhupada, 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 Jaya Jaya Prabhupada. Om Jnana Timirandasya Jnananjana Shalakaya Chakshurun Niletam Jena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Nama Om Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prashtaya Bhutale Srimate Bhakti Vedanta Swaminiti Namine Namaste Saraswati Deve Gauravani Pracharine Nirvishesha Shunyavari Paschatyarishatarine Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Srivasadi Gaur Bhakta Vrinda Gadadhar Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Srivasadi Gaura Bhakta Vrinda Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama,
Rama Rama Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Kali kukur kadam jari chao he Kali juga pavana kuli boy nashana shishachi nandana gao he Garadhar Madhan Nitayer Pranadhan Advaita Prabhujita Gaura Nimani Vishwambar Srinivasishwar Pakata Samua Chita Chora Nariya Shashadar Mayapurishva Nam Pravartana Shura Grihijana Shikshaka Nyasikula Nayaka Malavarala Bhava Pura Sarvabhoma Shodana Gajapati Tarana Ramananda Poshana Vira Rupananda Vardana Shanatana Palana Haridas Modana Tira Brajarash Bhavanda Dushamata Shatanda Kapati Vigatana Kama Shuddha Bhakta Palana Shuksha Jnana Tarana Chala Bhakti Dushana Rama Kali kukur kadam jari chao he Kali juga pavana koli boy nashana shishachi nandana gao he Hari Haraya Nama Krishna Yadavaya Nama Yadavaya Madhavaya Keshavaya Nama Gopal Govinda Ram Sri Madhusudan Gopinath Madan Moha. Sri Chaitanya Nityananda Sri Advaita Sita. Hari Guru Vaishna Bhagavata Gita. Shri Rup Shri Sanatan Bhatta Raguna. Shri Jiva Gopal Bhatta Das Raguna. Eshai Gosai Kori Charana Vanda. Jaha Huite Bignanash Habishtapura. Echai Gosai Jar Muitarda. Tansabara Pararinu Mora Panchagra. Tandela Charana Sheve Bhakta Shaniba. Janame Janame Hoye Abila. Chai Gosai Jave Braje Koilaba. Radha Krishna Nija Lila Koila Praka. Shishi Radha Krishna Nija Lila Koila Praka. Bolo Anande Bolo Hari Bhaja Vrindaba. Bolo Anande Bolo Hari Bhaja Vrindaba. Bhaja Vrindaba, Bhaja Vrindaba. Bhaja Vrindaba, Bhaja Vrindaba. Bolo Anande Bolo Hari Bhaja Vrindaba. Guru Vaishnava Padi Mojamiya Man. Shri Guru Vaishnava Pada Padma Gauriya. Harinam Sankirtan Kohe Narottamoda. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Go, go, go!
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Ram Hare Ram 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 Hare Hare
Hare Krishna Hare Krishna Hare Krishna
Krishna Krishna Hare 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 Ram Hare Ram 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 Hare Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Ram Hare Ram 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 Hare Hare
Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Ram Hare Ram 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 Hare
Hare Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Ram Hare Ram 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 Hare 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 Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare.
Hare
Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Govinda Jai Jai Gopala Jai Jai
Govinda Jai Jai Gopala Jai Jai
Govinda Jai Jai Gopala Jai Jai Govinda Jai Jai
Radha Ramana Hari Govinda Jai Jai
Govinda Jai Jai Gopala Jai Jai
All books must go
Govinda Jai Jai Gopala Jai Jai
Everything must go
Radha Ramana Hari Govinda Jai Jai
No book left behind
Radha Ramana Hari Govinda Jai Jai Govinda Jai Jai Gopala Jai Jai
Hey Govinda Jai Jai Gopala Jai Jai
Hey Ra Ra Ramana Hari Govinda Jai Jai Radha Ramana Hari Govinda Jai Jai Bajare Bhaja Govinda Gopala Hare
Hey
Bhaja Re Hey Bhaja Govinda Gopala Hare
Hey
Bajare Hey Baja Govinda Gopala
Bajare
Hey
Baja Govinda
Gopala Radhe Govinda
Radhe Govinda
Oh Radhe Govinda
Radhe Govinda
Oh Radhe Gopala
Radhe Gopala
Oh Radhe Gopala Bajare Hey Baja Govinda Gopala Hare Radhe Govinda
Radhe Govinda
Radhe Gopala
Radhe
Kishore Kishori, Radha Madan Mohan, Radha Shama Sundar, Radha Madhava, Radha Bhakti Hari, Bhajare, Bhaja Govinda Gopala Hare. Bhajare, hey, Bhaja Govinda,
Bhajare,
hey, I say Shri Ganeshama ko mere parampara pranam hai. I say Shri Bhagavan ko mere parambara pranam hai. Mere parambara pranam hai. Gaura pray bhadande. Nitai Gaura Hari Bol, Hari Bol, Hari Bol, Gaura Hari Bol. Nitai Gaura Hari Bol, Hari Bol, Hari Bol, Nitai Gaura Hari Shri Shri Radha Krishna Gokopi Na Shamkund Radhakund Kiri Govardhan Ki Shri Vrindavan Dham Ki Shri Mayapur Navadip Dham Ki Shri Jagannath Puri Ki Tulsi Devi Bhakti Devi Ki Save the Jamuna Ki Ganga Deva Ki Samaveta Bhakta Vrinda Ki All glories assemble the devotees. All glories assemble the devotees. All glories assemble the devotees. Gaur Premanande Hari Bol. Who cooked today? We'd really like to know. It's been kept secret up until this point. And now we're going to reveal. Hansapriya Mataji. Hari Bol. And who else? Malini Mataji. Hari Bol. Who else? Ramananda Saka. Haribo! Who else is back there? Swati Mataji. Haribo! Okay, everybody. This is it. We have two more days of book distribution. We have about 3,000 books to distribute between today and tomorrow. We have this whole stack of Chaitanya Charitamritas. Everything must go. Show it to everybody. Go to wherever you have to go. Drive up and down. If you have car, go by car. If you have foot, go by foot. Go show it at every store, every house, every barn. Drive to the country. Go to the countryside. If you find a chicken coop, show it to the chickens. We're looking for anybody. Everyone can see Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. He went through the Garakanda forest and he enlightened all the animals. So don't worry, if it's an animal, beast, bird, whatever it is, show them the Chaitanya Charitamrita and they'll start dancing in ecstasy. Right? Okay. So this is our goal today. This is all-out sincere effort to please Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu for Gaur Purnima. He said, I'm a gardener, and how many fruits can I personally pick and distribute to the rest of the world? He said, therefore I order every person to take up this task, to distribute. So now you have an order, and the order means
Krishna's mercy. If you just take that order, you'll be able to see Krishna face to face. Prabhupada says this in his purport in the second canto of the Srimad Bhagavatam. Face to face by taking the order. So don't worry how much you do. Don't worry what the result is. You're just an instrument for Lord Chaitanya. He told you to do it. And if anybody asks, anywhere you go, just say, look it, I was told to do this. I'm just doing what I was told. And if you do that, then your life is perfect. And these books are not ordinary. These are glowing globes from the spiritual world. They're actually the spiritual world themselves in written form that have descended this world. It's spoken kirtan. It's the kirtan of the greatest acharyas in the world coming right from Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, all in written form. That vibration will change anybody's life. They'll never be the same. So take it out, show it to everybody, go door to door, go store to store, go school to school, whatever you have to do, but show the book. Lord Nityananda used to roll on the ground. If you have to do that, do it. Somebody please try that today. If you have to, get on your knees. Buddhimanta used to do that. He was so enthusiastic about selling a book that he would get on his knees and he would beg them, please take this, please take it. And they would say, please, sir, get up. I'll take the book. But if you just get off your knees, I'll take it. And Lord Nityananda would roll on the floor. So we'll do that today. We'll do whatever it takes. Everything must go and no book. That is correct. Thank you, George W. Bush. He gets a little credit today, too, from Lord Chaitanya. Okay, George W. Now we're going to have prasadam. We'd like to thank from the bottom of our hearts Sri Govinda Datta Prabhu and the college preaching program, which has become one of the premier programs here at ISV. It's risen out of his sincere desire to see this expand to the universities, to give an opportunity to the most educated in society to become soldiers in the army of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. They have a training center, which is non-different from this temple room. It's all connected. It's all one building. It's just in different places. This is the way the spiritual world works also. There's Goloka and there's Navadvip. And they're separated, but they're one at the same time. And some people, they are in Goloka and Navadvip at the same time. You can do that in your spiritual body. So the Bhakti Center is the same as this temple room. It's just in a different location, that's all. And we are very proud of our college preaching program. It was one of the premier programs here in the United States. We thank Sri Govinda Datta Prabhu. Please give him a hand. A little more. That's about half. Give him a full. Yeah. And we see that at these programs, it is the devotees coming out of the Bhakti program, the Bhakti Center, who are making this program vibrant. It's vibrant. Without your efforts, without the efforts of all the college preaching devotees here, who are painstakingly going out, spreading Krishna consciousness at Stanford, Santa Clara, San Jose University, San Jose State. Where else are you? Intel. They're everywhere. They're getting all over the countryside here, so make no mistake about it. This is one of the most powerful programs in America, and we're very fortunate to have it here at ISV, confirmed by the bell. This is somebody calling in. Yes. That might be for a set of Chaitanya Charitamritas, and it might be George W. Bush. I'm not sure. If it says Texas, pick it up. Okay. That should be the goal today, to sell a set of Chaitanya Charitamritas to George W. Bush. Somebody try for that, okay? Just see what you can do. You never know, he might take it. Tell him we were inspired by your campaign, No Child Left Behind, and we'd like to introduce you to No Book Left Behind, and we have a set of Chaitanya Charitamritas for you.
Okay? Actually, all the devotees in Bhakti Center will be going out today afternoon to
Haribo! Okay. Our secret weapon, the Bhakti Center. Rakshit Jariwala Prabhu.
Just a brief statement that in addition to the Chaitanya Charitamrita sets, we have a large goal. We have other books also available, small books and book packs here at the temple. And this week we have also received the first canto of the Srimad Bhagavatam.
Oh, fantastic.
From BBT. So that's here also, and it's available.
Okay.
Yes.
They're beautiful. Take them out. People have never seen this before. It's the Sudha Goswami and sages at Naimisaranya. It's Narada Muni to Vyasadev. This is the most profound literature in the world. They're beautiful. People see them from across the parking lot, from you know, outside their window. They'll be clamoring to get this first canto. Yes, the sets are all in addition to everything else. Keep the volume on all the small books. Do thousands of the Srimad Bhagavatam, first canto, Bhagavad Gita. Stack everyone up with as many as you can, and sell sets of Chaitanya Charitamrita. Everything must go means not just these, but the whole warehouse, the whole bookstore. Okay, don't hold back. And if you have to, stay out all night. Go till it's all gone. Sarvabhauma stayed out one night for the marathon. He did 138 big books. It was the first time it was ever done. He stayed out all night long. In fact, there was no place to go. He got arrested, thrown in jail. They finally let him out, and it was past midnight. And there was no other place to distribute, so he went to the Playboy Club, and he distributed books there, and he kept going. And Prabhupada wrote him a personal letter afterwards thanking him for taking so much sincerity to distribute books. You don't have to go to the Playboy Club. I don't think there is one here, but don't go there unless it's the last place. But distribute all the books. Gandharvika.
Prabhuji, just wanted to say that Prabhuji distributed one Chaitanya Charitamrita set to his CPA whom he's assisting. So he's going to give that at 11 o'clock. I think that's a good start.
Haribo! That went to your CPA? To who? For your company?
No, he's owning company.
You work for him. And he's buying a set of Everyone sell a set of Chaitanya Charitamrita to your employer. Whoever's your manager or employer, call him up today and tell him we have this program, No Book Left Behind, that was started by George W. Bush. And we want you to take a set of Chaitanya Charitamrita. Seriously, we want all these sets to go. So innovate, talk to who you ever have to talk to, but get them to take a set of Chaitanya Charitamritas, and we'll offer this result. And plus, do all the other small books and everything else too. And pray hard, okay?
Yes.
There you have it. That's the orders for today. Trishab, he's got an idea. I can see it brewing.
Hare Krishna. Actually, I just wanted to add that we have a very nice shloka today that we can add to our application. It's a very nice shloka that we can learn while going on book distribution, and just going to make the book distribution like 10 times more happy.
Haribo! Haribo! So Trishab has inaugurated this shloka program during our book distribution. We did it the last 2 weeks, and when you're going door to door, you're waiting for people to open the door. You can open your iPhone, and this shloka will appear on the application. If you don't know about it, ask Trishab, he'll set you up. And you can recite the shloka in between. And you'll learn a whole shloka today just by walking around in between, right?
Yes, Prabhu.
Okay. What are we calling this program?
Prabhu.
Shloka on the go. Haribo. Let's hear it for the shloka on the go program. All right. Any other announcements? Yes. Okay. We have... Ramananda Saka Prabhu?
Yes, the announcement is that if anyone is, we are looking for some volunteers to help clean the temple after the program, after the prasadam has been served. If anyone is interested, please stay back for some time to help with the cleaning.
That will give you special power for distributing your Chaitanya Charitamrita set. So please help Ramananda Saka because he also wants to go out when he can. Right?
Yeah, I do want to go.
Okay. So let's be merciful to Ramananda Saka and let him out the door. Okay, now we have Sri Krishna Purushottam.
Vishnu Prabhuji, the Evergreen team is not at here, so we may skip that and we can go to Foster City. If they come in time, we can go to Evergreen also.
Okay, great. So we're going to have Prashadam. After prasadam, please, some devotees volunteer to help Ramananda Saka clean. Then we'll have an Evergreen team, we'll have a Foster City team, we'll have a cash and carry team. And everyone, always remember Krishna, recite your shloka, and pray for Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's special mercy. Monthly Sankirtan Festival of Abundant Bhajans Ki.
Yes.
Go Premanane. Sharirad Vijajal. Jodendriya Tahikal. Jibe Bele Vishaya Shogare. Dharma Jeti Bayati. Loba Mai Sudurmati. Takijita Katina Shangshare. Krishna Varadoyamoy. Kuribare Jihajai. Swa Prashad and Adilo Bai. Shayanam Rita Pau. Radha Krishna Gunaga. Preme Dako Chaitanya Nita. Ma Prashade Govinde. Nama Brahmani Vaishnave. Swapa Punyavatam Raja. Vishwaso Navijayate. Prasade Sarva Dukana. Hani Rasyo Pajayate. Prasanna Chetaso Yashu. Bhuti Pariyavatishtate. Bhagavat Sri Mahaprasad Ki Jai. Sri Man Mahaprabhu Ki Jai. Sri Sri Radhamanan Mohanji Ki Jai. Sri Sri Lakshmi Nishingadev Ki Jai. Srila Prabhupada Ki Jai. Go Premanande. Nitai Gora Haribol Adibol Haribol Gora Haribol. Please come take prasadam, Haribol.